Look at this inequality. And remember, if you look at accident probability function, looks like this. And if you look at this inequality, it means at x2 tilde, the slope is steeper than at x1 tilde. So this inequality means at x2 tilde, slope is steeper. So slope is steeper at x2 tilde, therefore x2 tilde must be smaller than x1. So x2 tilde must be smaller than x1 tilde. So we can combine these two. So let's draw a graph. So D1 is bigger than D2, and X2 tilde is smaller than X1 tilde. So here we have D1 bigger than D2, and X1 tilde is bigger than X2 tilde. So at point A, we have a maximum for our first isocost curve. And at point B, we have a maximum for our second isocost curve. So for our second isocost curve, so something like this, and for the first one we should have something like this. So if you want to draw many isocost curve, it's gonna be something like this. So as you can see over here, the maximum point is gonna move to the left. We can provide an interpretation of this finding. So remember our objective function. Our objective function is this. So this is our objective function in our problem. So we can interpret this as integer's cost. So integer wants to minimize this cost. So our interpretation is this is integer's cost. First part is integer's care cost. And if something goes wrong, then integer is gonna pay D. So second part is liability cost. So integer wants to minimize this total cost. And suppose D is really big number. So for integer, something goes wrong, then he has to pay a lot of money. Then naturally, integer wants to be really careful. So there is a big stake, then you should try harder. So when liability is really big, so integer has to pay a lot of money when something goes wrong, then in the beginning, integer is gonna be really careful. So in other words, if D is a big number, X is gonna be a really big number as well. So D is big, so integer expect to pay a lot of money when something goes wrong. then he's gonna be really careful in the beginning. And if D is a small number, so Indra expect a small amount of payment in the accident, then in the beginning, he's not gonna be that careful. So this is an interpretation, and naturally our isocost curve has this kind of shape. So maximum of this isocost curve is moving to the left as we go down the isocost curve. So this is our graph for our problem. So we found the isocost curve and we drew graph for our constraint. Now the only thing left is to combine these two. So we want to combine these two. In the x-axis, we have x. In the y-axis, we have d. And h is here. So u is here. And remember, we have kink when x is equal to u minus h. So and then we're gonna draw isocost curve. So we have this isocost curve in our picture. So remember, Indra wants to minimize cost. So the lower isocost is better for Indra because, for example, if you compare A and B, at point A, cost is bigger because according to our objective function, if you compare A and B, X is same, but D is bigger at point A. So Indra expects the lower cost at B. So therefore, because Indra wants to minimize his cost in our problem, lower isocost is better for Indra. So I1, I2, I3, let's say. Then for Indra, I2 is better than I1, and I3 is better than I2 in terms of cost. So if possible, Indra wants to move to lower isocost curve. But for example, I3 is not possible because imagine any point on I3, let's say this is point C. So imagine any point on I3, it is below our constraint. So remember this is our constraint, and consider any point on I3. Is below our constraint. So any point on this I3 isocost curve cannot satisfy our constraint. So according to our constraint, we should find a point on our constraint, not above or not below. So according to our constraint, we should find a point on our constraint graph, not above or not below. So for Indra, in this picture, I3 is the best, but he cannot move to I3 because it's below constraint. Then let's say, think about point D. Is point D our solution? So in other words, so let me write down our problem one more time here. So we are trying to solve this problem, subject to budget constraint. So this is our problem. We want to solve this problem and look at the point D. Is point D our solution? Look at point D. It satisfies our constraint because point D is on our constraint graph. So that's fine. And question is the cost minimized at point D? This is the question. And the answer is no, because there is a better point. For example, E. E is better than D because both D and E satisfies constraint. But at point E, cost is lower. So as I explained before, point E and B, so point E, point B, cost is the same. Point D and point A, cost same. But I saw at point B, cost is lower than point A. So point E generates lower cost than point D. So point E is better than D. Then again, is point E the best? And is point E our solution? The answer is no, because you can find a better point using the same process. Then what is the best point in this graph? So I can draw. So I can draw isocost curve. And at this isocost curve, look point F. At point F, this isocost curve is tangent to our constraint graph. And now we can see that at point F, we found the solution. So look at point F. Point F satisfies constraint because it is on our constraint graph. And moreover, cost is minimized. In other words, imagine this is I4. I4 is the lowest possible isocost curve we can move down. So we cannot go further down below I4. Because if you move further down, for example, I3, it is better in terms of cost, but it cannot satisfy our constraint. So I4 is the best. And imagine any point on this constraint graph, it's gonna generate a bigger cost, such as point E and point D. So F is our solution. So F is our solution. So let's say we found the solution. I'm gonna call X hat. So this means solution to this problem is X hat in our picture. What is our conclusion? So we suppose X is monetary. So X is monetary care. So now we have to subtract care cost X directly from injured asset. In this case, we try to solve our problem under strict liability. So we suppose, we suppose strict liability. And we try to solve injurious problem. So we try to solve injurious problem under strict liability. But it turned out the problem was not easy to deal with. So we transformed our original problem to another problem. And we eventually found the solution X. So when X is monetary care, under strict liability, injurer is going to choose X hat in this picture. So we found the solution to injurious problem, and now the final thing to do is to compare X hat and X star. So our next question is, we want to compare X hat and X star. So which one is bigger, X hat or X star? This is our question here. So look at this graph. Where is X star? This is our question. So where is X star? This is our question in this picture. So we want to find the X star in this picture, and then we can compare X hat and X star. So where is X star? So remember, this maximum point as this point. So I'm gonna use different color. Let me use green. So look at this green point. These are maximum point. And remember what's happening at this maximum point. At this maximum point, slope is equal to zero. So using that, we found this equation. So at this green point, this equation must be true. And we can see that what is X star? X star must be X star must satisfy this equation. This is what we know. So if you want to find X star must satisfy this equation. So in other words, if you want to find X star in this picture, D must be equal to H. So when D is equal to H, then at that point, we can find X star. So in other words, we're gonna draw isocost curve, and the maximum point is such that D is equal to H. Then at that point, we can find X star. So let's say, I'm gonna draw isocost curve such that D is equal to H. So because H is here, so we can imagine this point. So we can imagine this point over here. So we can draw isocost curve. Then at this point, we can find X star. So in this picture, as you can see, X hat is smaller than X star. So we can say Injera is gonna put less care than socially optimal level of care. So in this picture, we found X star, and we can see that X hat is smaller than X star. Therefore, our conclusion here in this case is Injera is gonna be less careful than socially optimal. So in this case, interpretation is very similar as before. So Injera is judgment proof. So he doesn't have to fully compensate the victim. And in this case, Injera is going to be less careful than socially optimal. So interpretation is very similar as before. But there is another possibility. So, let me draw a graph one more time. So let me draw a graph. Let's say, in this picture, we have H here. So if you look at this green isocost curve, D is equal to H. So we can see that we can find X star at point A. So look at point A. A is the maximum point of this green isocost curve. And D is equal to H. Therefore, at point A, we can find X star. And let me draw, so we can find the solution in this picture using our previous logic. And let's say I'm gonna draw isocost curve such that, so I'm gonna draw isocost curve . This is the maximum over here, and I'm gonna draw isocost one more time. Then we can see X hat is here. So if you look, at this graph, solution to our problem is X hat. So in this case, Injera is going to choose X hat as solution. So under strict liability, Injera is going to choose X hat. In this case, you can see that X hat is bigger than X star. So what does it mean? It means Injera is more careful than socially optimal. So Injera is judgment proof, and he is more careful than socially optimal. So this is a very interesting result, and it's very different from our previous result. So in our previous result, when X was non-monetary, remember, when Injera is judgment proof, Injera is always less careful. So X hat is always less than X star. So remember, we are thinking about strict liability. So under strict liability, when we studied non-monetary care cost, we found that under judgment proof problem, Injera's choice of care X hat is always smaller than X star. But here, when we suppose X is monetary, integral could be, in this case, X is bigger than X star. So integral is more careful than socially optimal. So even when integral has, even when integral is judgment proof, his level of care could be bigger than X star. So this is a crucial difference between monetary care and non-monetary care. So in non-monetary care, integral's choice of care cannot be bigger than X star, but when X is monetary care, it is possible. So integral's choice of care can be bigger than X star. So why is it so? Because so suppose X is non-monetary. So suppose X is non-monetary, then there could be accident, or there could be no accident. So when X is non-monetary, if there is an accident with probability Px, what is the cost of one unit care? So suppose, so we want to think about cost of one unit care. So let's think about cost of one unit care. So integral is careful by one unit, by one additional unit. Then what is the cost for it? So suppose X goes up by 1, and suppose X is non-monetary, in this case, what is the cost? If there is an accident, we're gonna subtract X from integral's payoff, so cost is 1. If there is no accident with probability 1 minus P, we still subtract integral's cost from integral's payoff. So when X is non-monetary, we always subtract care cost from integral's payoff. So if X goes up by 1, cost always go up by 1 when X is non-monetary. And now suppose X is monetary. So think about monetary care. And integral is judgment proof. So available asset is lower than H. So integral is judgment proof. In this case, if there is accident, then what is cost of care? In this case, if we write down integral's payoff, so think about integral's payoff. If you write down integral's payoff when X is monetary, if there is an accident, what is integral's payoff? It is equal to 0. Do we have X here? No. So care cost X does not appear in integral's payoff when there is an accident. So care cost does not influence integral's payoff when there is an accident. So we can say cost of one unit care is equal to 0 when X is monetary. We consider integral's care cost only when there is no accident, because in that case, we can write down integral's payoff as U minus X. So if there is no accident, we write down injuries payoff as u minus x. So in this case, care cost matters for injuries payoff. So in this case, one unit care is gonna increase care cost by one. So crucial difference comes in this case. If there is an accident, we subtract care cost from injuries payoff when care is non-monetary, but we don't have to consider care cost when x is monetary. So this is because injuries payoff is gonna be just equal to zero when x is monetary care. So when something goes wrong, in that case, injurer just gives up whatever he has. So he just lose all his asset in this case. So care cost doesn't actually matter in this case for injurer. Therefore, in this case, so care is non-monetary. Cost of one unit care is equal to 1. But in this case, cost of one unit care is equal to 0 with probability p. It's equal to 1 with probability o minus p. So in this case, we can say cost of one unit care is equal to 1 minus p dollars. And remember, p is probability, so this is less than 1. So cost of 1 unit care is less than $1 when care is monetary. What is the implication? Implication is cost of 1 unit care is now lower. So cost of 1 unit care is lower when x is monetary than when x is non-monetary. So when care becomes a monetary cost, we can say care cost gets lower because of this logic. So this is an important finding. So when x becomes monetary, so care becomes monetary cost, monetary care. One effect here is cost of one unit care is decreasing. So cost of one unit care is decreasing, then injurer's natural response could be to be more careful because cost is lower. So marginal cost of something is lower than the agent naturally increases its activity or consumption. So in this case, marginal cost of care gets lower, therefore, injurer has incentive to increase his level of care. So there are two effects going on here. So first effect is, as usual, if injurer is subject to judgment proof problem, then naturally he has incentive to lower his care. So this effect is what we know from our previous analysis. So when injurer has judgment proof problem, naturally he has incentive to lower his care. But when x is monetary, there is a second effect. Injurer has incentive to increase his care. Why? Because marginal cost of one unit care gets lower. So there's an opposite effect going here. So on one hand, injurer wants to reduce his care, but on the other hand, injurer wants to increase his care. Because of these two opposing effects, maybe in certain case, x hat is lower because first effect is dominant, but in others, Second effect is dominance, so injury may actually increase his level of care. So this is why in this picture, X hat is lower than X star. In this case, we can say first effect is dominant. But in this case, X hat is bigger than X star. And in this case, we can say second effect is dominant. So when X is monetary, we have this second effect. So marginal cost of care gets lower. So because of this second effect, we have more complex result in this case. So injury choice of care can be bigger or smaller than X star, depending on these two effects. So, and depending on graph, it is possible that integer's choice is exactly equal to X star. So, for example, so we have X star over here, and I draw. So another isocost curve, and we find X hat is over here. So in this case, X hat is exactly equal to X star. So there are many possibilities depending on graph. So depending on those two effects we saw before, it is possible that X hat is lower than X star, bigger than X star, and it is also possible that they are exactly equal to X star. And we have one more thing to talk about here. So this point is very important. So this point is very important. And remember for this green area, remember, u minus x is lower than h in this green area. That's why in the beginning we had this graph for our constraint. So for this green area, we have u minus x is lower than h. So therefore, in this case, integer is subject to judgment proof problem. Because u minus x is available asset and h is liability, so liability is bigger, so integer is judgment proof in this case. But for this red range, available asset u minus x is bigger than h, so in this case, integer is not judgment proof. So this means, in this picture, we have X hat. So integer choice is X hat. And integer choice of X hat is in the area of judgment proof. And remember, in the beginning of this section, I said integer is going to choose whether he wants to be judgment proof or not judgment proof. So when X is monetary, it is integer's choice whether he wants to be judgment proof or not judgment proof. So in this picture, X hat is in the area of judgment proof. Then it means integer choose to be judgment proof. And especially in this picture, integer choose to be judgment proof, and his choice of care is exactly equal to X star. In another graph, for example, So for example, X star is here, and we find X hat here. And again, remember, this X hat is in the area of judgment proof. So in this case, Indra choose to be judgment proof, and his choice of care is lower than X star. Is it possible that Indra choose to be not judgment proof? Yes, it is possible. How can I describe such a situation? Look at this graph. In this graph, this green point is Indra's choice. So this green point is X hat. So at this green point, look at this green point. It satisfies our constraint because this green point is on our constraint graph. And this green isocost curve is the lowest possible isocost curve we can go down. So X hat is the solution to our problem. So Indra is choosing X hat. And in this picture, as you can see, this X hat is in the area of not judgment proof. So in this case, we can say Indra chooses to be not judgment proof, and his choice of care is X hat. And moreover, where is X star in this picture? X star is also equal to X hat in this picture. So in this case, Indra choose to not judgment proof, and his choice of care is equal to X star. So this is what we studied in this section. As you can see, it's slightly complex because when X is monetary, there is a second effect that marginal cost of care gets lower. And because of this second effect, there are many possibilities, as you can see here. So first thing to remember is marginal cost of care is decreasing when X is monetary. And second, remember when X is monetary, Indra has to choose whether he wants to be judgment proof or not. So when X is non-monetary, whether you are judgment proof or not is given to you. But when X is monetary, you have to choose whether you are judgment proof or not judgment proof. So this is the end of our study of monetary care.